Hello everybody, I want to talk to you really quick about pulling down strongholds in your life, and it is a very serious thing right now. The enemy is waging war against the minds of believers, and what his job is to form strongholds, fortified places in your mind of unsound, places of lies in your mind, so that it can keep you trapped, it can keep you bound up, it can keep you discouraged, it can get you into a place of depression or rage or just isolated. The enemy wants to keep strongholds in your mind, not just one, but one on top of another, on top of another, on top of another. And we see believers every single day. We see believers every single day with these strongholds. I'm going to put a link right here in the description of this video. If you're watching the replay, you can just go to the link in my bio. Tonight, I'm going to be teaching on pulling down strongholds, literally destroying them. And here's the thing. When I say pull down a stronghold, it's not you just going, whoop, I'm pulling it down. That is nice, and it's good to, you know, give yourself some sort of action, some sort of prophetic gesture, but that's not how you pull strongholds down. And we need to understand how to get into this stronghold and literally rip it apart and get it out of our minds. How to identify what a stronghold is. Some people go, oh, that's just my thought. And people can't even distinguish now from their thought, a thought planted by the enemy, a flesh thought, a stronghold, a word curse that's manifesting into thoughts. Like, there's so much to it. So I'm teaching tonight. I'm giving everybody the opportunity to join me. I'm going to pin this link. Why did I not pin it before? I'm going to do it now, though. My apologies. I'm pinning this link. Or not. Maybe I can just type it again. If you want to be in the core group, you need to join. If you don't know what the core group is, it is a place of revival. It is a place of real transformation. It is a place that God is moving. It is a place where people are literally testifying every single day. Not just, oh, we're going to testify after you do a live. No, every single day without even watching any of my videos, God is the one doing the work. Amen. I wish I could pin this. Okay, thank you, God. And so the core group is open. It is open for ladies. It is literally $5. $5 a week is your dues. That's going to cover all of the different platforms that we use to host the core community, all the Zooms, all the PDFs that you get, everything included in the school is there. So if you are drinking a Starbucks coffee once a week, put the coffee up and get the core group. It is vitally important right now for you to get connected with believers who don't just want to sit on pews and high-five a neighbor and leave out the same way that they came. I don't know about you guys. Maybe you guys like that. And if you do, that's fine. But I don't want any part of it. Any part of it at all. If the core group has been on your mind, this is your sign to get into the core group. Also, if you don't, someone said, I can't afford it. That's why I love the Instagram, the YouTube, the Facebook. I post content on there every single day for free, so that you are able to just have. Another thing. Oh, Abednego, yes, yes, Abednego, yes, that would be wonderful. I would love to have Aaron in it. Love to have Aaron in the core group and for you guys to go to Israel. We are planning a trip going March 1st through the 8th. We're going to Israel. The core group is going, and it is a great package deal that we got, all inclusive, the flights, everything for 8 days. We're starting core meetups this week. So the students are able to gather locally. Other students are opening their homes, their churches, their community centers, and the students are just gathering. They're finding a place near them. You can only find the places if you're in the core group. You can only attend them if you're in the core group. I don't want just a whole bunch of craziness going on, a whole bunch of different doctrines, and a whole bunch of people laying hands all over my students. Like, it ain't gonna happen. But if you just want to go and do your own thing at your own church, have at it. But when it comes to the core group, I have a mandate and assignment from the Holy Ghost, and I'm not budging for anybody or anything. I have to stick to the course. And so they are going to, our core group students are going to gather. They're going to come together, and they are going to have, we're going to have these meetups, and I'm going to be leading them virtually. So it's just going to be amazing. Someone said, do I do deliverance? The interesting thing about doing deliverance, since it's an online school, this is what happens in our core group. Students watch the lessons, the teaching goes in, and God does the work while they're sitting at home having coffee in the morning. People are literally testifying, I went through deliverance all of a sudden. Because the teaching goes in, and the Bible says, and you'll know the truth, and the truth will make you free. And so it's not me calling them up and going, come out. I can't do that with 2,500 students. When we get together, all the students are going to come together for a big gathering. We have seasonal gatherings. Then yes, I can do that. But no, it's not like join the core, get deliverance. No. Join the core, get the word. God delivers you the way that he wants to deliver you. And that is the best way. Plus, at these core meetups, you'll be able to have a sister there with you, ladies. That's holding your hair back, praying with you, and that's a very natural, organic way. And the core group is for international students. The core group is, we have South Africa groups, we have UK groups, we have New Zealand, we have so many things. We've got a book club. I teach live on Tuesdays at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I also go live on Wednesdays mornings for prayer and devotion at 9 a.m. on Wednesdays, and then throughout the week I just do random pop-ups, random worship sessions, random just anything. And then on the weekends we do a freedom broadcast where our focus and our topic is freedom and breaking chains and liberty and all that good stuff. We just have so much going on, so much. It's amazing. I have Zoom, I have Facebook Live, and I have a new core community platform. So if you don't like social media, you get into the core. Once you sign up, you can actually join our community. It's interactive. Everybody's in there chatting and talking. I just created it 2 days ago. Are you still doing the shop? Yeah, I still have the t-shirt shop, but right now the focus is training and equipping women. So I've been able to delegate a lot of that. I do lots of different things throughout the day. Thanks be to the Lord. So this is our core community. Right here you see welcome. You see book club. You see core meetups. See all that? You see testimonies. So if I go in here, I can look at all the different testimonies. This. Can we sponsor someone so they can join the core in your area? Sure. But the thing about it is you don't have to join a core in the area. So let me go back and explain. The core group is an online group. So every week, all students come together from all over the globe and they're trained and mentored and in class with me. Once a month, we do these special get-togethers. That's what that means. So you don't have to find a place near you. That's not the purpose of the core group. That's just an additional byproduct of us developing fellowship and community in our local cities. Does that make sense? Okay, so I've been doing this, started the mentorship in 2018. So it's online with these once a month meetups and then seasonal core group retreats. You're welcome. At any time I can explain it. Core group retreats, and I put on the core group retreats myself. It's not like the students have to pay to come to these big gatherings that we have for a few days in Florida, wherever. Me and my husband, we take care of the venue and all the costs that it takes. We do that to bless the students so they can come and actually get impartation and refreshed and fellowship and the word and all the good things that God has for them. So it's a beautiful community. Haley said that core group is the best, and she would know, she's in it. So we just have, and I'm excited to teach tonight on pulling down strongholds, and I believe that people are going to really get freedom. Some people for the first time in their lives. Some people are gonna actually know, wow, I don't have to live this way. I can actually live free in Jesus Christ. The enemy doesn't have to torment me every single day. God's given me the authority. God's given me the power to move forward in my calling, my assignments, my mandate. I don't have to live this way, bound up, always struggling, always crying, always going through mess. No. That's not my portion. There's a better way. And I would to God that churches would begin to teach your people. Please start teaching your people how to overcome the enemy. We already had enough teachings on being blessed. Oh God, help me. I know that I'm blessed in the city and in the field and coming and going. Now, how can I get these word curses off my family in the name of Jesus? Teach me that. Teach me how to bind up the devil. Teach me how to walk in the glory realm of Jesus. Teach me how to press in the morning. Teach me how to fast. Teach me how to seek his face and not always his hand. Teach me. Churches, equip the people. Watered down mess. I'm sorry. This offends you. Stop giving them watered down mess. We don't care about a nice service anymore. What? Ugh. I don't want your programs. I don't want your nice little to-dos. Well, now you have 5 minutes of this, and now we're going to have 2 minutes of this, and we're going to have seven. We're going to let the Holy Ghost move for the next 15 minutes, and if he doesn't move then, we're moving on, with or without him. That's not how the core group is. At all. If I ever was to have a church, it would not be like that. Would the Lord even allow me? I wouldn't have it like that. I wouldn't. We're going to put all the famous celebrity people on the front row. No, not at our place. Everybody get back and open up the front rows for the children. Let all the little kids come sit on the front row. Let them be the VIPs. Let the children see the move of God. Let the homeless people come up to the front row. Let the prostitute off the street, let her come up to the front. I'm so done with the way that church has been done. It is just, it's sickening to me what people have made God's house like. So, sorry, I got off on tangent. I am teaching tonight. Join my core group. It's like you join a school, but you enter into revival. Like, God, what are you doing? How? It's just wild. No more church as usual. We don't want church as usual anymore. We don't want it. We don't want it. We want the real thing. Can I recommend a church in LA? I wish I could. I don't know the area well enough to recommend a church in LA. I can't recommend a church anywhere. And the only one that I can firmly say y'all can go to is under Apostle Ryan Lestrange if you were in the Atlanta or the Alpharetta area in Georgia. Because the only one I can, that's not the only one in the world. It's the only one that I can actually confirm. I know Marcus Rogers is doing a great work over there in Chicago too. It's the only one that I can confirm. Unless, of course, you live. And then if you live in my area, in the Florida area, in the Tampa, Lakeland, Plant City area, go to Awaken Church. That's where I go. So I love you guys. And I will see you in class tonight. The link is right there. Bye-bye.